These are the things that are going to help us. Enzymes operate in a bell-shaped curve. Optimal functioning is right in the middle of that curve. If you get too little or too much minerals, vitamins, and they don't work properly, so it shuts down a whole pathway of functioning in your body. So what do we need? We need a vitamin that will give us that, and that's exactly what LLD does. That's not the only thing it does, but that's one of the very important things. A lot of other vitamins don't seem to do that. They give you too much, too little. This hits you right where you need to be. LLD will also, I'm not going to go into the individual components of the LLD. We only have a half an hour. And I do have a 3-hour lecture on the LLD that I love to give, but we don't have time for that today. Actually, my wife wrote the lecture and I just added on to it, so I stole her lecture. But it helps you produce energy. One thing that you may notice if you use the LLD is you'll just feel better. You just feel you can do more. I've had this happen with numerous people that are using it. Why? Because it helps you produce energy. It helps you take the fatty tissues, produce them into energy. It helps that be produced and ATP produced, adenosine triphosphate, which is the main source of energy in our body. And it happens over and over that it helps us produce more energy. The other thing it does, this helps our cells function. We had a scientist out a little earlier that talked about the importance of cellular functioning for numerous reasons. I believe he was a cancer researcher here in Utah. These cells help our cells, these vitamins help our cells function properly. When your cells are functioning properly, you don't have any type of problems related, we were talking about earlier. So, at the mitochondrial or cellular level, you're going to be stronger. You're going to be healthier. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is the phytoestrogen lifetime complex. Depending upon your age or menopausal level, I usually say that you can use that in different ways. Premenopausally, a lot of patients I see like to use it symptomatically. If they're having any menstrual disorders or menstrual symptoms, they may use it at that time. By the time their patients get into the perimenopausal phase, a lot of times they use it more on a daily basis through menopause. Now, the phytoestrogens in the phytoestrogen complex, along with the flaxseed and lignans that are in there, help your body function in a proper level, the way it wants to, the way that you will feel better, stronger, and healthier, and you will likely not have the issues that bring you into the doctor that were really there for. Gives women excellent menstrual support of their menstrual symptoms. Go back one slide. I want to go back to the slide before this, if you could. So I want to talk about the bone nutrient complex, and I still want to talk about very common. Bone nutrient complex. Women's maximum bone density will be achieved somewhere between the ages of 20 and 30. You only get one chance to build bone density. That's when you're young. Supplementing calcium, vitamin D, and the minerals that are in the bone nutrient complex are what are going to help you prevent bone loss and having issues related to bone loss later in life. Bone loss and fragile bones can even lead to hip fractures, and in the elderly, even death. So supplementing early, especially through puberty, and then throughout the end of life. I usually recommend the calcium be about 1,300 milligrams through puberty, down to about 1,000 until the perimenopausal phase, and back up to 1,300 milligrams after. Let's talk a little bit about Clericalm. Clericom is used a lot with my patients to help ease symptoms around their menses, and then a lot of patients love to use it through the perimenopausal and menopausal phase. All right, let's go one slide here. Pregnancy. All right, guys, you're excluded from this one, I'm sorry. All right, let's talk about pregnancy and some of the symptoms of pregnancy that we can ease. The first trimester of pregnancy. Classes are considered through the 12th week of pregnancy. A lot of patients will have stomach upset. And what can you use for stomach upset? There's a lot of things, but there's a lot of problems with the current medicines today that we use. Recent research on Zofran now is showing that was our big go-to medicine. Now we're showing congenital abnormalities with the use of Zofran. So more and more, we're finding there's more problems. Tylenol or acetaminophen, we're finding issues with that. So these things we gave out like candy in the past are now finding issues. So the natural approach, one of my favorites, personally and in my patient population, is Digestin for stomach upset. I find it's extremely effective, and I actually have a bottle in my pocket right now. I use it very frequently, especially on times when I've been on call for 36 hours and haven't slept in a few days. Other options, lavender, excellent option for stomach upset. Peppermint, use it for stomach upset and pregnancy. I find it to be very effective. Of course, ginger. Ginger is an excellent choice. And peppermint needles. Abdominal discomforts happen in the first trimester. They'll get more frequent as you go through pregnancy. But in the first trimester, sometimes you'll get some pain right around in this area. Sometimes where there's a ligament there called the round ligament. Someone will get that as the uterus starts to grow. I found that a blend of marjoram, black pepper, ginger, and frankincense are one of my favorite options for that at this stage. All right, second trimester. The 13th week through the 27th week, your abdomen's starting to distend, you're seeing a little bit more of that baby's there, and you're probably later in this trimester feeling baby's movement. You're possibly starting to, your center of gravity is getting a little different. Getting a little more gravity pulling down out here. And your lumbar spine is changing its orientation, it's getting more like this. So this is where maybe the pregnant walk is starting. So there's a real physiologic and anatomic reason for the pregnancy walk. But in this stage two, the uterus will sit in the pelvis. And it's an obstruction for blood flow. So your aorta and your iliac arteries are super thick, strong arteries, and they are high pressure. So the blood will flow down to your lower extremities. Your veins are flimsy little light little vessels, right? Easily compressible by a 27-week uterus as the blood's trying to flow back to your heart. So you may get some venous discomfort in the lower extremities. Any dependent area we call hands or lower extremities, the blood wants to stay, it gets a little stasis. So, what can we do about those symptoms? I'm a fan of sandalwood. Sandalwood's an excellent oil. I've had personal experience with sandalwood when I injured my knee, and it's amazing for any type of venous discomfort. I'm also a fan of helichrysum and lavender as a mixture. I find it to be very effective. Another blend that's very effective is Aromatouch. Lemon and ginger And the last oil, but not the least oil, would be peppermint. Difficulty with sleep during this phase of pregnancy. You start feeling less comfortable. Your doctor tells you you have to sleep on your sides. You can't sleep on your back. Obviously, you can't sleep on your stomach. What can we do about that? Well, I'm going to say, from personal experience from last night, the new blend is amazing. Exceptional. Slept very well and woke up without any drowsiness. Otherwise, the classics, lavender and pepper. I personally love to diffuse oils at night. My wife loves to spray on her pillows too with a little lavender. It's very pleasing. I always equate lavender and pepper together. It feels like I'm sleeping in a lavender bed with mulch. All right, now we're getting close to pregnancy here, right? We're getting excited. 28 weeks till delivery, the third trimester. An exciting time, a nervous time, but also a time when the symptoms increase even a little bit more. Skin irritations increase, especially over the uterus. You'll notice it gets a little itchy sometimes. I'll have patients come in and they have big marks on their bellies because they're scratching. And we will check and make sure there's nothing more wrong. There's, you know, making sure that it's just a symptom of pregnancy and not a medical condition, of course. But what would we use when we find out it's really a symptom of pregnancy? I like Immortelle. Patients have found that that's very effective. Citrus Bliss is another very effective blend. Lavender, of course, lavender is good for most things, and frankincense. But we may have a new oil that may be just as good as frankincense we got, right? So that's awesome too. And add another name on that list. And helichrysum. I like helichrysum for a lot of things. I tend to use a lot of black pepper in everything I do. I find that's one of my favorites for blending. But helichrysum is an exceptional oil with a lot of value. Rectal irritation. Anybody who's been pregnant may know what I'm talking about. You get that pressure in the venous system. Also affects the anus. So, what can be an effective use for rectal irritation? Sandalwood again, another oil I like very much. Helichrysum and peppermint. Peppermint in that area, you gotta be a little cautious because it can. So, a little asterisk next to that one. And then perineal support. Perineal support is in the third trimester of pregnancy. I with my patients, put a lot of a combination of lavender, helichrysum, and frankincense on the perineum. Anybody who doesn't know what the perineum is, it's the backside of the vagina. I put that there, and I find it eases the irritation and pains in that area in the third trimester of pregnancy and through labor, and I use it straight through labor. I don't stop there, and then I recommend a spray postpartum. So that's a big part of the third trimester, is working through that phase. All right, and a couple other things I wanted to note too. I didn't put it on these slides, but mental and emotional health is a huge part. We had the lecture earlier today on this, and I can't agree more than 1,000% with what was told to us earlier. I recommend finding a Zen place. Whatever your Zen place is, you need to find that and be there. Because what is here is here. All this is designed to carry us around and to nourish this. That's all this packaging is. You gotta nourish this, you need to find your Zen place, yoga, meditation, whatever that may be. And on that, my time has ended. Thank you all very much.